Hi, I'm Jochem, an engineer at Thameson, and today we're going to talk about compressed air. First, I'll explain how compressed air is created, and then I'll tell you what measures you can take to increase the life of your compressed air system. Compressed air is made from the same air that is around us. That air is compressed into a smaller volume and held under pressure. When you take atmospheric air and then compress it into a smaller volume, the molecules take up less space and the air is compressed. Because the air is under high pressure, it is stored energy that has the ability to perform work. This is the energy source that is used for pneumatic systems. Air contains moisture. The amount of moisture that air contains is indicated in percentages of relative humidity. 100% humidity means that the air is completely saturated and therefore can no longer absorb water. This is when condensation occurs. Relative humidity depends on the temperature and air pressure. Cold air under high pressure can absorb much less moisture than warm air under low pressure. So you can imagine that the moment you compress air, the humidity will go over 100% and condensation will form in your system. To prevent corrosion, it's important that the air is dried after compression. Good air quality is important for a long life of your system. Air can contain particles such as soot, pollen, dust, or water droplets. Depending on the components using the compressed air, it may be wise to filter the air to prevent contamination and damage. A common way to filter out the main contaminants is to use a pre-filter. This filter is placed immediately after the compressor before the air enters the system, removing the largest particles. A filter in combination with the regulator is often placed directly in front of the application to regulate pressure, remove residual moisture from the air, and remove smaller particles that have not been filtered out by the pre-filter. Overall, compressed air is very safe. It is simple, efficient, and there are no dangerous exhaust fumes. However, it can be dangerous if used in the wrong way. Due to the high pressure in compressed air tanks, these tanks can explode if they are not properly maintained. Therefore, always check for corrosion on your tanks. Also, never point a compressed air gun at a person. Compressed air blown into the ears or eyes can cause serious damage. Always work safely. So, compressed air is stored energy used in pneumatic applications. It can be used, for example, to operate a blowgun, to move a piston in a pneumatic cylinder, and to atomize paint for spray painting. Those are a lot of applications for a simple principle. If you found this a useful video, click the like button and subscribe for more videos. And if you have any other questions about compressed air or its pre or post treatment, please contact me or anyone else from Thameson.